marketing for C Spire, and C Spire is a merging tier two provider. And what Suzy is going to do is provide a perspective on what they're doing with gigabit communities and some really exciting stuff. So with that.
Okay. Great, thank you. I've noticed a couple of themes here today that are very consistent with the C Spire culture, and that's speed and change. And I think when you see kind of what we've been working on for the past year, you'll see what I mean with that. So on September 24th of 2013, last year, we announced a Fiber to the Home initiative. We announced a contest, and we allowed the cities of Mississippi to compete to be the first to have fiber to their homes. The key product for that, of course, was a gig to the home. And we have been pretty transparent about the fact that we completely followed Google's model on their Fiber to the Home initiative. We've learned some things, we've changed some things, but that was the beginning and the impetus of our plan and how we approach Fiber to the Home. We also are bundling into that high-definition television, home phone, home automation and security, as well as our wireless services. You probably don't know a lot about C Spire, or some of you may, but we have been in the wireless business for over 26 years. Our parent and sister companies have been in the telecom business, the cable business, for over 60 years, I believe. So we have our roots in telecom. And our plans and pricing are pretty simple on purpose. I think that's one of the benefits of being a new entrant is we can keep it very simple. The speed for internet is, there's not a lower option, it's a gig. And we also allow bundling with phone and TV. The base is the internet. And as I mentioned, we do give you a discount if you have our wireless service as well. So that's the product. And I think what you might be even more interested in is our method of deployment and what we've learned along the way. One thing that is a little bit different about us is that we're very well positioned to bring fiber to the home because we have an extensive fiber backhaul network throughout Mississippi. We have, we have been providing cable services via our sister companies. We have a lot of experience in providing all of these services already. So that makes us a little bit unique. We also have great relationships with our communities. We're talking about public and private partners. This is really a story about private and public partnership. Neither our cities nor C Spire could have done this on our own. It is a true partnership in how we're bringing fiber to the home and a gig services to Mississippi. We also have been technology leaders. We're on the enterprise side. We're putting in a data center that will open before the end of the year. It'll be one of seven in the North America that is a tier three plus or four rating. So that's part of our plan as well. And all of our services work together. One thing that we knew, because of our history in providing wireless in our communities, is that I think sometimes people have the perception that Mississippians are not as interested in technology as perhaps somebody in New York City. That is really and truly not the case. You might be surprised to learn that our customers actually use smartphones at a faster rate than the rest of the industry. Back years ago, they used talk and text a lot earlier than the rest of the industry. And that's because over time, we have very purposefully helped our customers be ahead of the adoption curve via rate plans, via education, initiatives that really have been about putting our customers at the forefront of technology. Fiber to the home is really an extension and an evolution of that. And we knew that our cities would get it. You know, I think that still there are, we were just talking about this a minute ago, there are still places in the world that don't get that people are going to need more bandwidth. Well, they are. But our cities do get it. And at the end of this, I'm going to play a couple of clips for you from our mayors, or two of our mayors, and you'll see what I'm talking about. But you hear them talk about things like, we know that it increases home value. We know that it drives economic development and that we will attract new businesses. We know that it is a great opportunity, particularly in rural communities, for things like telehealth. All of those things are going to change the lives of the citizens of our fiber to the home cities. And education, I think that is another really critical piece of it. We have currently over 300 schools that have C Spire fiber today. One of those schools, my two teenage children go to. Well, one of them's not quite a teenager, but she thinks she is, so that counts. But I have a 16-year-old and I have an 11-year-old, and they were the first school to have the official Apple Distinguished, whatever they do to get that. But and so they have, beginning at 4 years old, they have iPads. When they get to the fifth grade, they transfer to Macs. They've had the program in place for 2 years. I can already tell a difference between what my two children are learning. My 11-year-old already has an advantage over my 16-year-old because she started earlier in how they learn. They don't do papers anymore. They shoot videos and they edit them and they email their homework and they, you know, I don't understand why they still have to have the big backpack, but apparently we haven't come as far as we'd like. And in Mississippi, you have to think about, too, that we have a lot of children who don't have broadband at all. So we will be bringing not just broadband, but a gig to the homes of our children, and our children will be more competitive than the children of larger cities. So that is what our cities and our company that we get really excited about. And this is our timeline. We've been talking a lot about speed. We say internally that C Spire years are like dog years, so a week for everybody else is a day for us in terms of how long it takes us to get things done, because once we focus on something. As I said, we announced on September 24th of last year the Get Fiber First contest. We had 33 cities respond to an RFI in under 30 days. That was the time that we gave them. We had, on November 4th, we announced that we had selected 9 cities to be in the first round. We were going to have 3 to 5, but we had so many great applications that we expanded it to 9. By February, we had 4 fiber hoods that went green. That means that they qualified for fiber to the home. That also means is in Mississippi, we don't have the density that you have in Kansas City and other places. So we had to have 35 or 45% penetration in order to agree to build to those markets for our ROI. And we achieved that in under about, 2 months and a couple days. So, which is really, if you think about getting 50% of anyone, of any group to do anything, is really astounding and really says a lot, I think, for our city leaders and what we've been able to do as a partnership. We decided that we didn't have enough to do, so we decided we would start working on home automation in April. And then we began construction in May. We are already in the pilot phase, and we will be launching before September 24th. Because our goal is to have the service up and going within a year. And then home automation, we did give ourselves an extra month because it came in so late, but still a pretty tight time frame. And this is just a glimpse of the 9 cities. So these are the 9 cities that are in the first round. That's 81 fiber hoods and 83,000 homes. And this is how we did it. When you think about getting 50% of any group of people to agree to anything, we really did approach it as a partnership with our communities. And here are some examples. So we found out very quickly that if we led the effort, we would not get the results we needed to get. We really needed the cities to step up. And the cities where the mayors got involved and all of the city leadership got involved are the cities that went green first. We can see that the city of Quitman, which you'll hear their mayor speak, that's the population of 2,300, and I tell you, those houses are not that close together. So that definitely, we required at least 45% to make the model work for their for them. They had their own Facebook page. We have Jimmy the Fiber Truck, if you're interested in following Jimmy on Twitter. He goes to all of our Fiberhood events. We did things like food trucks. I mean, you cannot go into these neighborhoods without knowing about fiber to the home and what a gig of service could do for your lives. The mayor of Ridgeland, Mississippi, which is where our headquarters is, had a cycling race to get to raise awareness. And there were many other things. We have a blog full of things that our cities did on their own with our marketing support. So essentially what we did is we lent them our marketing department. And we worked with them as they drove the efforts to go green. And here are the results so far. We've had 8 Fiberhoods go green in 4 cities. 3 of those cities have had a Fiberhood over 50%. Their goals were either 35 or 45%. We are also in the process now of expanding that to additional cities. So look for those in the next coming weeks. We'll be announcing several new cities here shortly that are coming on board. So meanwhile, we kept it to the 9 cities so we could focus on getting the service up. But meanwhile, we've had cities all over the state beating our door down to come to their city. And here's just a few clips. So we've essentially, we have had some pretty high numbers and press results in the past. When we announced our name change from Cellular South to C Spire years ago, when we were the 4th carrier to get the iPhone, we had a pretty impressive media results. But this has topped them all, for sure. And I could talk to you all day about this because this has been my life for the past several months, and it's really, really fun to see our cities come to life, but I think it's really helps to hear it straight from the source. These are our mayors, Mayor Eddie Fulton from Quitman, which, by the way, they only had 1 Fiberhood. That was the whole town. Okay. Oh, click on the word mayor.
I was asked to speak about what has happened since C Spire came. I've gotten calls from New York Times. I've gotten calls from Kansas City. I've gotten calls from California. And I don't know what in the world. I said, they want to know, how in the world did a small city like Quitman get fiber? C Spire has taken upon itself to come to a city of only 2,332 people and make a difference. And what difference is it going to make? Channel 4, remember this, Channel 4 in Quitman will be the school channel. We'll have a television studio in the school. The school is already going to spend $35,000 to get the equipment. We have WTOK out of Meridian that's going to help us with the training to do this. We'll have kids presenting the weather because we have our own weather station. Well, in Quitman, we're going to have training for our school. We're going to have training for our churches. We're going to have training for the citizens. We're going to hire somebody to do some of that. We're going to have a business community, an incubator shop for it. All of these things happen from things that our governor had vision to see and a great company, C Spire, has brought to the table. So as far as I'm concerned, I absolutely love C Spire. I love our state, and I've lived 18 places in my life. I will never leave the state of Mississippi. This is too fine a place with too many fine people and with too many companies that have a heart for making us grow, and that I'm very proud of. Thank you.
Quitman has a city planner coming in, so I'm real excited to see what they come up with for that. It's a really beautiful town, and I expect that you're gonna hear more about them. Their goal is, I think I could tell because we were at the city meeting when they were saying this, that there must be some dissension on becoming too big, because he did say their goal is to get to 3,000 population. So. Okay, you want to go to the next one? The next one is the city of Starkville, Parker Wiseman. This is also where our data center will be. It is also the home of Mississippi State, so it's a university town. And Mayor Wiseman and his team actually went to Chattanooga the day before we met with them and told them about our contest. And so when we met with them, they quickly said, sign us up, we're going to be first, whatever it takes. And they were very happy for us to build it and for them not to have to find a way to pay for it. So.
This is truly a monumental day for our city. We did spend some time over the last year traveling to Chattanooga, Tennessee, learning about places like Lafayette, Louisiana, and Kansas City, Kansas, and what was happening with ultra-fast internet in those communities. What we found out is it's a game changer for those communities. It looks different in each of those communities, but we saw enough, and we've seen enough activity going on throughout the United States that we came to realize that we are in the midst of a major technological revolution. I can say that confidently, that over the course of the 21st century, we will look back on fiber to the home, gigabit internet initiatives, like we look back at other major technological revolutions in our history. Advantages that can't be undone once this becomes standard technology. That's why we believe it's important. We believe it's important for our citizens. It will make a difference today in the life of our citizens. Most households now rely on an internet connection for day-to-day services, like downloading and uploading basic internet content. Increasingly, households rely on a connection for video streaming. Those services are going to be vastly improved by bringing a gigabit of capacity into the household. It's also noteworthy that of all the fiber to the home initiatives that are happening now all around the country, this is the first statewide fiber to the home initiative. And that tells you a lot about who C Spire is. C Spire is a Mississippi company. They are headquartered in Mississippi. In addition to providing us with great consumer services, C Spire is a corporation with a vested interest in moving the state of Mississippi and its people forward. And that's what this project is all about. We could not be more thrilled to be partnered with you, and we are excited about the way you are changing our community. Thank you so much.
You can see the state of Mississippi gets it, and you will be hearing from our cities, and I'm very excited to see how all this plays out. So we very shortly, next month, we'll have the service up and running. Like I said, it's in pilot stage right now, and our goal, I probably shouldn't say that out loud, especially in this room, but they don't have to do it, is to have, 15 go green by the end of the year and an additional 40 next year. So I'm looking forward to the day when we're seeing these presentations and you show that map and Mississippi is entirely covered up and other places that are much larger than us are not quite caught up. I was going to say left behind, but that's kind of ugly. So, okay, so does anyone have any questions? Yes.
So Mississippi.
Very true.
Statewide ranking. Our state.
Are thinking of this education, yes. But what about on a statewide basis? Is there any interest there?
Yes, our governor, I mean, I think you heard Mayor Fulton mention this. Our governor has been very instrumental in that as well. And, you know, that is one thing. I mean, and I think that's, you know, Mississippi is on the top of a lot of lists, most of them not very positive. And I think that's almost that extra thing about this project is that the people of Mississippi are ready to change that. And our children will have a competitive advantage over children from New York City. And that's saying something. So Yes, it is a, in the rate that we're moving at and the pace that we're moving at, we believe we can change the school system very quickly. The city of Quitman actually is getting up on our fiber network as we, well, they already are because it was in time for school to start, so. Yes?
Can you talk about the customer or prospective customer education piece that had to happen, making them understand what is a gigabit, what does this actually bring, why is it different than the internet service you might already have? What was that effort and what was the response from those folks?
Right. It's really twofold. So one thing that we did is we got in front of our community. So once we knew which cities were on board and the city leadership was on board, and like I said, they had to drive it. If we tried to drive it, it turned into a commercial for C Spire, and it wasn't very effective. And we kind of went that way a few times and veered back. But we had a lot of town hall meetings where we talked about it. The business leaders talked about it. In Quitman, and I had a clip from the Reverend, but I didn't include it, the church was very involved in educating the community. The people that were champions for it went door to door and explained it to people and how it could change. And we really learned quickly, too, that it's not just about the speed. You know, if we started to talk about it in terms of you need faster internet, then you become, frankly, a Comcast commercial. And then you're just talking about the same thing everybody else is talking about. What we had to do was to tell the story that's bigger about how we can change lives in our communities. And so that's really where we focused our messaging, was around what it can do for the economy, how it can bring jobs. The Quitman mayor mentioned, you know, just a little bit backstory of Quitman. They're obviously a very small town. And if you grow up in Quitman, then you really have no choice but to leave and go somewhere else to work. So that town has been dying. What the Reverend said, and I didn't put it up here, but was that they actually consider this initiative to be an answer to their prayers of saving their city. And so that is a pretty powerful message for people. And they want to be able to raise their children and have those children stay there and be prosperous and to have jobs and to attract people who maybe want to get off the fast pace of city life and come live in a smaller town. I think a lot of us think about that. I mean, I live in a medium-sized town of Ridgeland, Mississippi, and I think, you know, I drive it in Quitman, there's a lake, I'm like, oh, this could be nice. You know, so it really, they have a really interesting story, I think.
So my first thought as I was hearing this is, I mean, it's great. It's great for the community, great for the state. I'm thinking, good golly, you know, how does a public corporation make that investment? So I just looked it up. You're a private company. Can you say who the, you know, kind of the owners are or majority owners, something like that? Is it like the communities themselves?
No, it's a family. And I think C Spire has an interesting story. It's a family, and they're very humble, and they don't like to be talked about. but they're very prominent in the city of Jackson and a very, very nice family. And, you know, they're in it not just for the money. They really have always wanted – we've always been very involved in our communities, which is one of the reasons we could do this in the time that we can. We already knew all these people. You know, we already had those relationships. We've been already giving – to the communities, giving in scholarships, giving in money, and we have a foundation, you know. So, so it is privately held. Now, I have had the question, and I know I can answer this question. We do plan for it to be profitable. So it is a lot of money. We have a lot of, it does help that we have all this fiber in the ground, but it's very expensive even then to get all the way to the home, obviously. And that's why you see us doing things like adding additional services. And that's why we are anticipating that it's also going to increase our share in wireless, which is really our bread and butter. So there is definitely a business plan that goes along with it. It's not just to make us all feel good about doing something nice for Mississippi, although that is part of it. Yeah.
Yes.
I'll let you pick.
Did you require any type of upfront financial commitment from the customers? You showed some statistics with respect to, you know, interest levels. How is that determined, and what type of commitment did you require to make a fiberhood go green?
We did, and it was $10, so it wasn't really overachieving. And we'll give that back if we decide not to go there. So, yeah, we've been converting those to contracts as we've made the commitment to build, and we've had a very high success rate. So that was one of the fears, because it's a little bit of a gamble in that, you know, they've only committed $10, so what if we build all this and then they don't come? But we have really, that has not been the case. We have, we've seen very good take rates, and we expect it to get better as we go into the neighborhoods. You saw some of the branding, but all the trucks are branded. I mean, you know when C Spire is in your neighborhood. And so we have been selling more, actually, to people who had missed the first wave.
So you're following the Google model pretty much down to the T of the $10 pre-registration fee. Mm-hmm. But I'm curious, because you're in a lot of cities where they are not wealthy communities. There's a lot of people that are financially challenged, I would say. And you're offering a single gigabit service at a minimum of $80 a month. So unlike Google, are you choosing to do something that provides free internet or lower cost internet to these people who can't afford $80 a month? Because for some families, that's a pretty pricey amount of money. So I'm curious what you're doing there.
Now, we are really keeping it simple at this point. So so we don't have a different option at this point. But right now, in order to get the return that we need to get, the first wave of it, the $80 is the minimum. But we're also working with Mississippi State and the people there that are very interested in the digital divide, and looking for ways to get to those homes that need a more affordable option. So we are working on that as well.
So what was typically happening as far as broadband goes to the home in those 9 communities before you got there? Did they have DSL? Did they have a satellite option? Did they have an MSO there?
It's a mix. Now, I've talked a lot about Quitman, but on the other end of that, one of our first neighborhoods is a neighborhood called Bridgewater in Ridgeland, and they have million-dollar homes with very large lots. That community has cable access and they have broadband, and you know, in Quitman, though, they didn't have as many options. There are some neighborhoods where they really only had satellite, but most of them have competitive services already.
When we first heard about it at Broadband Communities, we ran the business, all the possible scenarios that we could think of through our own business models to see how you're doing, and 80% of the cases were profitable. But because you're a private company, we don't know your balance sheet, we don't know your cost of capital, we don't know your IRR targets. But we do know that construction costs tend to be lower in Mississippi. The places you went into are fairly easy to deploy into, because you have invested in a pretty good network, and because the federal government and others have invested in networks that you tie into, the business case looked surprisingly scrumptious. As I say, we could wreck it with higher interest rates than I think
you're
paying.
I don't know if I'd call it scrumptious.
Yeah, you know, that sort of thing. We've been, and of course we've written you up, but we've been kind of surprised at some of the skepticism. So we think your biggest problem is probably going to be managing the systems once you build them. And could you talk a little bit about that?
Right. Well, keep in mind, too, that we have people already on staff that have done this before. We actually had provided fiber to the home, not a gigabit, but a fiber to the home to a few small communities prior to this. So we have the experience to do that as well. And we have great vendor partners as well that are very instrumental in managing the services.
Any other questions?
Thanks.
That was great. Really appreciate it. All right, so it was a little light lifting today. Not, we didn't over do it with way too many presentations and stuff. So at this point, we're actually a few minutes ahead of schedule. But so you'll be able to go back to your hotel, take care of whatever you need to do. And then I guess the buses come back at what time? 6:15 to 6:30? 6 and 6:45. And so on those buses will be, you know, the other broadband providers. And so you'll be coming back. So just those of you who haven't been here before, you know, we're on about 83 acres. We have about 1.1 million square feet. About 1,700 of our 2,200 employees work here in this facility. And tomorrow you'll be able to see we pretty much every product that we develop, we can manufacture here. And so you'll be able to see some of that. That's a core competency that's rare and a great competitive advantage for us. And please, if there's someone you didn't talk to or you want to talk to or something you want to see or deep dive on anything, just let us know, and we'd be happy to do that. So with that, we'll see you guys tonight. And it's going to be casual, some barbecue, I assume. And is that what we're having, Kevin? Where's Kevin? Barbecue and some... you know, kind of laid back time on the lake tonight, and it's going to be perfect weather. So thanks a lot, guys.